In this video, you will learn to create frequency tables using StatCrunch. The data set I am using is called two categorical variables. This is just a toy data set that contains two columns of data. In this video, I will focus on the var1 column that contains 10 values, the value of B in 4 rows, and the value of A in 6 rows. Let's begin by creating a frequency table for the var1 column. To do so, under the Stat menu, choose Tables, Frequency. I'm going to choose the var1 column and click Compute. The resulting frequency table shows the frequency and relative frequency for the values of A and B. StatCrunch allows the user a number of options for statistics to be displayed in the frequency table. To view these options, under the Options menu, choose Edit. This takes us back to the original window where we built our frequency table. In this window, StatCrunch allows the user to customize their frequency table. In the Statistics box, you will see a number of different options that can be added or removed from your frequency table. To add or remove, hold Command on a Mac or Control on a PC and highlight or deselect any of these values. For this example, I'm going to deselect frequency and leave only relative frequency highlighted. I'll click Compute, and now the resulting frequency table displays relative frequency for each value only. Notice by default, StatCrunch orders the value in ascending order, or in this case, alphabetic order. To change this ordering, we can go back under Options, and in the Order By box, you'll see the different options StatCrunch provides. Value Descending will reverse this order. Count Ascending and Count Descending will order the table by the frequency of the values rather than the values themselves. For this example, I'll choose Value Descending and click Compute. Now you can see the value of B comes before the value of A in a table. Just a note that ordering can have a big impact on any cumulative statistics that are included in the display, because these cumulative values are computed starting at the top value and moving downward. StatCrunch also provides the option to combine values with a small relative frequency into an other category. Back under Options, you will notice the box labeled Other if percent less than. For this example, I'll enter 50. This will group all values less than 50% into one other category. I'll click Compute. And as you can see, the B values are now labeled as Other. Also, you will notice that StatCrunch has changed the orders of the value in the table. The Other category will always appear last. As you can see, it's really not that great of an idea for this data set, but it also shows how StatCrunch can create this category if needed.